be nice and you can go and send me on my way. I said, just such a sweet old thing, why you do this to yourself? She looked at me and this is what she said. Oh, there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free.
All right, Baghdad, time to wake up. It's a beautiful day, full of opportunity.
No rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good. Not even 15 minutes later, I'm still walking down the street when I saw the shadow of a man creep out of sight. And then he stepped up from behind, he put a gun up to my head. He made it clear he wasn't looking for a fight. He said, give me all you got, I want your money, not your life. If you try to make a move, I won't think twice. I told him you could have my cash, but first you know I gotta ask, what made you want to live this kind of life? He said that
it was a dark and stormy night. Sheesh. On a distant corner of Pandora, where few men dare to tread. With the journey to find the elusive vault behind them, our fearless adventurers set off into the trees of...
What's a tree?
Oh, for the angel's sake! It's a plant that grows out of the ground really tall.
Like this?
No more interruptions. So, they set out into the trees of Jacob's Cove, a land very much ravaged and forgotten by time. It was here that the scientist Dr. Ned, who is totally not Dr. Zed from the last story at all, tried to help all of mankind, but ultimately caused very bad shit.
That's a swear!
Dude made zombies, okay? You're not the police of me. Pay attention. Okay. So some bad crap was happening. And it got really spooky. And this is when our story begins.
Is any of this going to be true?
Yes. Probably a lot of it. You're adopted.
medicine form zombie fodder? I am not affiliated with the Jacobs Corporation, but they packed me to tell people like you that they would appreciate some assistance with the overwhelming situation with the living impaired. I should warn you, though, that they'll suck your brain out of your cranial cavity like a crappuccino if you get too close. If you'd still like to help, I suggest you turn on the town's defenses. Otherwise, crappuccino. Toodles!
Found some help.
Always do.
should be safe for now. But if you're really going to solve the zombie infestation, you're gonna need to talk to Dr. Ned. He's been trying to fix the problem, and I'm sure he could use a hand. You'll find him at his office down on the docks. I'll open the waterfront gate so you can be on your way. Let's go!
Just can't carry enough bullets for your favorite gun? Sounds like you need a storage deck upgrade. Supply limited. Your grenades should do more than just explode. Customize your grenades with a new mod today.
Loot.
Don't go falling in love with me, stranger! I've been hurt too many times. Bye, zombie.
This is amazing. made it all the way here alive. I'll get the lift down, but it'll probably take a bit to hand crank the bastard all the way to you. Probably want to shoot any of those skull munchers that trottle in.
I probably went about this all the wrong way. I'm a doctor. I make people better. I just wanted everyone to be okay. I made the zombies. I was never as good as my totally not made up brother Zed, and we're totally different people. I need a drink.
Well, how nice to see you.
Well, if you want to help a decrepit old man who created an end-of-the-world epidemic, you'll have to head to the old hospital past the graveyard near Jacob's Cove.
That's what I'm doing.
You'll need to find a sample of an antidote I was working on. I based it on skag DNA, since they don't seem to have undead tendencies. Get the sample and bring it to my claptrap in town. Oh, almost forgot. The gatekeeper of the hospital grounds was lost a long time ago, but there is a more spooky way in. Just look for the old gravestone on the beach that doesn't belong.
Amazing. That hurt. I see a health vial.
crap ain't enough for your ailments, visit my infirmary on the water in Jacob's Cove. Choose Dr. Ned before you're undead.
Killer. New missions are available at the Jacob's Cove Bounty Board.
Maybe I'll even let you get shot in.
Whether you are killing bad guys or exploring the unknown, you need a trusty gun by your side.
Ha! Think you could take me?
Feeling.
Now this is loot. Seen anything like this?
Sweet! Wasn't expecting that.
cap carry enough bullets for your favorite gun? Sounds like you need a storage deck upgrade. Supplies limited. The Lance are the best armed mercs out there. You need something better. Don't let the Lance get the upper hand. Get a better gun today.
Ah!
goodness! Get me the hell out of here! We have precious little time!
Before you go up and help that lying mobile toaster, you'll want to hear this. Dr. Nate is not who you think he is. And he's about as trustworthy as my dog I put down for being untrustworthy. Whoa! Whoa! Ooh, where'd that come from? Gotcha! Oh boy. Hey, whoa! Just kidding around here. Just kidding around. Really feel free to forget everything I just... This is all true. But don't take my word for it. Look for yourself. Take the boat tied to the pier to the lab on the other side. You'll find a door in the town that will require a special knock. I love special knocks.
Whoa!
I'm possessed.
The knock sounds like this. Now go and leave this robot for the skags.
Don't turn your back on me unless you never want to turn your back on anything ever again. Wait, that was a crap threat. Can I try again? Killer. New missions are available at the Jacob's Cove Bounty Board. Okay, I'm sane now. No more evil, no more weak.
dead before you're undead. Zombies trying to tear your face off by shield and then by an insta-health. For when the shield inevitably goes down and you really need it.
By sword, I mean, he's now crapping his bones in the yard. The good news is, he's already paid me rent, and I don't have to listen to him bitch about toenail clippings that totally weren't even mine. Not to mention the popcorn shenanigans. Consider this my solemn promise to begin attempting evil for the sake of profit from this point on. My brother, who isn't even the same as me in disguise, would never...
Testing? This is the first official entry of my greetings, loyal Nedcast viewership, now in the third week of my clinical trials with corpse reanimation. The skin cells have reacted well to the treatment, but the bodies themselves seem to have uncontrollable hunger. Right now, it seems all they crave is brain food. But I fear with strength applied to the cell reanimation, their hunger will grow much stronger and possibly dangerous.
Don't fight. Christmas. armament team.
Transportation is inbound. Be sure to avoid the satellite-marked landing zone. Anything standing in that location will have its face melted off. The Jacobs Corporation marginally regrets if that face was yours.
not to hurt your girl parts on the multitudes of minions I've set upon you.
Wasn't expecting that.
Professional mercs.
They're heavy, accurate, and effective, assuming you're strong enough to hold one.
Thank you.
It's like having another one.
Want one? Shit, wait. I forgot about me trying to shove you off this mortal coil. Can't be giving brownies to just any vengeance-driven D-Wad now, can I? Hey, you know zombies like brownies?
Jacob's paying you. I'd offer to double it, but I'm poor as dirt after spending every cent I had into the recreational use of the undead as moneymakers. So far, not digging my plan in hindsight.
Oh,
at your side. It's hard to seek new opportunities with old equipment. Upgrade now.
Found some help.
You smell like popcorn. Now I'm pissed.
The Vault Hunters had stopped the evil Dr. Zed from...
I thought his name was Ned.
Yes, yes, whatever you say. Where was I? Oh, yes. And so, Dr. Ned was stopped. Thanks to the courageous Vault Hunters. And me.
You? That doesn't make any sense.
What? You? Bedtime, you little... Good night, dirty little orphan.
I've never seen anything like this.
Killer. New missions are available at the Jacob's Cove Bounty Board.
I'm really good at this.
Thank you. Anna. I've arrived at Jacob's Cove, and you'll be pleased to know it seems a jolly and lively old town. I know being away from you and the children will be difficult, but it's only for a few cycles. The pay is just too generous to pass up. I'll work hard here and be back to you and the girls soon. My brother will take good care of you in the meantime. Love, Hank.